Coming up on 5 Minute News. Military officials say a Russian jet collided with an American drone over the Black Sea. President Biden signs an executive order on gun control. And double whammy of storms hit east and west coasts. It's Wednesday, March 15. I'm Sunta Templeton. A Russian fighter jet struck the propeller of a US surveillance drone over the Black Sea in a brazen violation of international law, causing American forces to bring down the unmanned aerial vehicle, according to US military officials. The incident, which raised tensions over Moscow's war in Ukraine, appeared to mark the first time since the height of the Cold War a US aircraft was brought down after being hit by a Russian warplane. US President Joe Biden was briefed on the incident by National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan, according to White House National Security Spokesman John Kirby. He added that US State Department officials would be speaking directly with their Russian counterparts and expressing our concerns over this unsafe and unprofessional intercept. State Department spokesman Ned Price called it a brazen violation of international law. He said the US summoned the Russian ambassador to lodge a protest, and the US ambassador to Russia, Lynn Tracy, has made similar representations in Moscow. The US European Command said in a statement that two Russian Su-27 fighter jets conducted an unsafe and unprofessional intercept of a US MQ-9 drone that was operating within international airspace over the Black Sea. It said one of the Russian fighters struck the propeller of the MQ-9, causing US forces to have to bring it down in international waters. Prior to that, the Su-27s dumped fuel on and flew in front of the MQ-9 several times before the collision in a reckless, environmentally unsound and unprofessional manner, the US European Command said in a statement from Stuttgart, Germany. This incident demonstrates a lack of competence in addition to being unsafe and unprofessional, it added. US Air Force General James B. Hecker, commander of US Air Forces Europe and Air Forces Africa, said that the MQ-9 aircraft was conducting routine operations in international airspace when it was intercepted and hit by a Russian aircraft, resulting in a crash and complete loss of the MQ-9. He added that, in fact, this unsafe and unprofessional act by the Russians nearly caused both aircraft to crash. The Russian Defense Ministry says a US drone sharply maneuvered and crashed after an encounter with Russian jets near Russia's border, and the Russian jets did not use weapons or impact with the drone that came down in the Black Sea. Moscow has repeatedly voiced concern about US intelligence flights close to the Crimean Peninsula, which Russia illegally annexed from Ukraine in 2014. President Joe Biden signed an executive order on Tuesday aiming to increase the number of background checks to buy guns, promote more secure firearms storage, and ensure US law enforcement agencies are getting the most out of a bipartisan gun control law enacted last summer. The Democratic president outlined his latest efforts to curb gun violence in a speech from Monterey Park, California. In January, a gunman stormed a dance hall in the community near Los Angeles and shot 20 people, killing 11 following a Lunar New Year celebration. The action does not change US government policy. Rather, it directs federal agencies to ensure compliance with existing laws and procedures, a typical feature of executive orders issued by presidents when they confront the limits of their own power to act without cooperation from Congress. The order directs the cabinet to work on a plan to better structure the government to support communities suffering from gun violence. Forecasters are warning both the east and west coasts are facing a double whammy of powerful storms, with California facing potentially catastrophic flooding as the northeast braces for a powerful nor'easter. A coastal low is expected to strengthen rapidly into a major coastal storm that will significantly impact the northeast through Wednesday, according to the National Weather Service, with 23 million people across the northeast and New England already being placed under winter alerts. The Weather Service warned early Tuesday that rates of 2 to 3 inches plus per hour and strong winds were expected to make travel dangerous to impossible. It said the heavy and wet nature of the snow, combined with maximum wind gusts of 55 miles per hour, would also likely cause power outages and damage to trees. In California, the Weather Service warned that excessive rainfall over parts of the state's central and southern areas could cause severe widespread flash flooding that could imperil lives and property. The warning came as a front extending from the northern Rockies to central California was expected to bring a wave of low pressure onshore over the Golden State. The storm's expected to bring heavy rain to parts of California where 26 million people are under flood alerts and high elevation areas face heavy snow. The Weather Prediction Center issued a high risk of excessive rainfall over parts of central and southern California through Wednesday morning in preparation for the storm's impact.
You can subscribe to the 5-Minute News Patreon for bonus videos, commentary, and more. Go to patreon.com/5MinuteNews.